about. Maybe you'll sign in some babies. Come on, won't you be my lady? Forever's gold. I'm ready to commit to you. I just can't wait for that night. Cause I need you here with me. The start.
I'm Same as I can take it down. Time of song, as we just had opening with Amazing Grace, to kind of set us at peace, the grace of God, in a time of scripture, a time of prayer, and even a time of sharing, a time to reflect on her life. We begin with a blessing with holy water, a reminder of the first sacrament of the church, the sacrament of baptism. Waters of baptism, as he died with Christ and rose with him to new life, may she now share with him eternal glory. And the candles, the reminder of Jesus Christ, true light of the world, certainly surrounded by these photos of family and certainly of great accomplishments as well. Brothers and sisters, we believe that all ties of friendship and affection, which knit us as one throughout our lives, do not unravel with death. Confident that God always remembers the good we have done and forgives our sins, let us pray, asking God to gather her to himself. Lord Jesus, our Redeemer, you willingly gave yourself up to death so that all might be saved and pass from death to life. We humbly ask you to comfort your servants in their grief and receive Lizzy into the arms of your mercy. You alone are the Holy One. You are mercy itself. By dying, you unlock the gates of life for those who believe in you. Forgive any sins she committed in human weakness and grant her a place of happiness, light, and peace in the kingdom of your glory forever and ever.
The readings from Scripture. First reading is from the first letter of St. John. See what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called the children of God, yet so we are. The reason the world does not know us is it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. The word of the Lord. This first reading, the Apostle St. John reflecting that it is from the love of the Father that we be called children of God. And as I mentioned in the introduction, we enter the family of God through the saving waters of baptism. We're children of God, brothers and sisters of one another, so it doesn't matter one's age. In a sense, we are all children of God, the family. We are God's children now, but we shall later be, has not yet been revealed. But when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. That's a theological term, the beatific vision, the vision of heaven. We can see God as he is, the Holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And that's our hope, and that's our prayer for the faithful departed, that they are in the fullness of peace, in the presence of Almighty God, of the communion of saints with the choir of angels. From Psalm 103, merciful and gracious is the Lord, slow to anger and abounding in kindness. Not according to our sins does he deal with us, nor does he requite us according to our crimes. As a father has compassion on his children, so the Lord has compassion on those who fear him. For he knows how we are formed. He remembers that we are dust. But the kindness of the Lord is from eternity to eternity toward those who fear him, and his justice toward children's children among those who keep his covenant and remember to fulfill his precepts. I'd say some very consoling words of Scripture. Merciful and gracious is the Lord, slow to anger and abounding in kindness. In a certain sense, the patience of God, merciful and gracious. And again, a call for us to follow as our Lord taught, be perfect as your heavenly Father is perfect. So for us as well, to strive to be gracious and merciful, slow to anger, and abounding in kindness. In the gospel passage, a reading from the Holy Gospel according to John, Jesus said to his disciples, do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way. Thomas said, Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The Gospel of the Lord. It's at times such as this that when this gospel is proclaimed, I can almost hear the words of our Lord from the Last Supper echoing across time, telling his disciples, and this was right before his own death on Calvary for our redemption, do not let your hearts be troubled. Have faith. I am going to prepare a place for you. Again, very profound, not easy for those who are left behind to continue to persevere. Our Lord's words, do not let your hearts be troubled. In the sense, if you can imagine a guest coming to your home and you prepare the room, get everything all ready, it's an image that the Lord has prepared a place for the faithful departed. And as Scripture has it, eye has not seen, ear has not heard, nor has the human mind conceived what God has prepared for those who love him. Jesus said, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Our Lord and Savior, the reason for our hope. By the cross, our Lord paid the debt for human sin, reconciled humanity to the Father, and by the resurrection, opened the gates of heaven and calls us to follow. There is a great sense of loss in family and community, in a greater perspective. There's certainly a sense of loss, but yet it's not without hope. One of the signs of affection in our culture, especially at times such as this, is flowers. And we can see the great affection and love both here and over in the Heritage Hall, the great sense of outpouring, as well as all of the messages online and cards and letters a great sense of affection, and certainly our prayers and support to all of the loved ones here and all over as well. Our Lord understands. Remember, as Scripture has it, our Lord wept at the tomb of his friend Lazarus, and Jesus is here with us as we weep as well. We'll have a prayer tomorrow in the Mass, our prayer for reunion in the Father's house, in God's time, according to his plan. We don't understand the divine plan, and yet we can trust in providence. No one is promised tomorrow. In just a few days, it'll be the 9th anniversary of my father's death, and when I found him in his home 9 years ago, he had a massive heart attack and fell to the floor, and he had dropped his Walmart card. He was intending to go to Walmart. The Lord had other plans for him. Mike, you're not going to Walmart today. I have other plans for you. Again, we go forward day to day, trusting in providence, trusting in the mercy and the grace of God. It is at times like these, and I usually try to, I'm over here about once a week or so, to view the photos and to read some of the notes and things that people have shared on the flowers and other ways. And to see, you know, and this one was beautiful, all of the sense of family. I can say a word that came to mind for me was passion. Passion for life, passion for family, passion for the great outdoors, out on the water, out in the woods, being out with pets and animals, passion for life, exploring many things, and for art, as I heard about that, great artistic ability. And, of course, there's a passion for speed in there somewhere as well. So we can see in the fine machines out front and in some of the pictures and things as well. Again, we admire someone of passion, of that having that sense of drive, you know, of an internal discipline and going forward. And especially in this particular sport, I can remember when I was younger watching it sometimes on television, Saturday afternoons and things, and just kind of picture the sense of the scene, of the, you know, all of the teamwork that went into this, mechanics and technicians, the even watching on TV, imagining the smell of the tires, of the smelling the smoke, you know, the oil and fuel. And even as I remember studying physics long ago, the concept of acceleration, you know, such a short distance to accelerate to such a high speed. Again, that takes a lot of passion, I think, to not only desire that, but to be very proficient and excellent and disciplined in such that is. Again, our time here is a time of prayer, eternal rest, our prayers of hope that we will see her again, and also a sense of prayer for the family and all the loved ones, and that sense of sharing those memories. And there'll be many, many greetings this afternoon. I pray for the family as well, because I know in my own experience, it's going to be a long time, and there'll be many, many guests here. So certainly my prayers are with you, and certainly to do your best with that and try to get a break when you can, because it's a long time this afternoon. Gone from this life, yet not forgotten, and you will continue to love her. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his. In baptism, Lizzy received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord. She was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord. Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. We pray to the Lord. Those who trust in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. We pray to the Lord. Comfort the family, friends, loved ones. Heal their pain. Help them to persevere in the spiritual life. We pray to the Lord. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of our Lord's coming. We pray to the Lord. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. And we pray together as our Lord has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. At this time, if anyone from our congregation here, from the chapel, the family or friends, if anyone would like to just share a few brief words, a memory, something, you can come up here or even do that from your place. So I'll sit down for a moment and just see if anyone would like to share anything at our service today.
Sure. Yeah, this is, yeah, that way it's on the tape and everything.
Thanks. I'm trying not to make him angry, but 6 years ago, I pulled up to Musi Racing Engines on a moped. I don't know how I got the job, but I did. Not long after that, I met Lizzy for the first time at a PDRA race. She had this beautifully sweet yet superstar aura around her. At my first race, we went to the finals in Maryland. We did some motor swaps, we got in some fights, got yelled at by Pat, all things I'd do 100 more times with Lizzy. From that point on, I went through thick and thin with this girl. From racing in the Pro Mod car, the street racing, and MPK, I've helped her build two cars, two front halves, long days, longer nights, thousands of road miles, test passes in a gas station parking lot, probably hundreds of motor swaps, at a few 4M Waffle House victory dinners, yeah. I'd do it all again for her. I knew early this girl could drive. I wasn't there a month before I saw her pass, where her front tires never touched the ground from the start line. Like. But her best work came on the street. It was 34 degrees out. We came out with an aftershock with a 959. We're racing Chuck Seitzinger. Halfway down the track, the car pitches 90 degrees. And somehow, she pulled a 3G turn on skinny front tires to pull it back straight and keep it off out of the dirt and rolling over. We never showed Pat this video because we were pretty sure he would kill us or tell us to go home. She was also super tough, and she'd kill for her family. I not only saw her put Jerry Bird in the fastest and tightest headlock of all time. And look, I was a little jealous because that was my move. She stole from me. I'm still a little mad about that. But also when she found out that Pat was fighting Dwayne Mills, the first thing she did was kick off her fancy shoes, tie up her hair, and take out her earrings so there's nothing for her to grab. This girl was a savage, and she's ready to go to war for the ones she loved. Even the day of her diagnosis, when most people would shrivel up and into a pile, she got back into the seat and laid down 3-second passes one after the other. Her spirits remained high even after she lost her hair. We went out and won a race, well, actually two, but in her trophy fixtures, her wig had slid far back. Yes. Most people would be super embarrassed, and look, she was. But we turned that into a saying, man, that pass slung my wig back. And I think that speaks to who Lizzy is as a person. Strong, driven, kind, and inspirational. It wasn't the race car. It wasn't her clothes. Or anything else. It was the person underneath. 2 months ago, she told me I wish I was normal again. And I hate to break it to her, but she never was. I met the real Lizzy Musi, not the one you see on TV, but the real Lizzy Musi. And she was anything but normal. She represented me for the last 6 years, and I'm honored to call her my friend. I'm thankful for the opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you for sharing those memories, which have enriched us. And we'll have time tomorrow as well. I'm sure there'll be many people at the church who will want to express their memories as well, either before or after our funeral mass. Let us pray. Almighty God, through the death of your Son on the cross, you destroyed our death. Through his rest in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe in you. And through his rising again, you restored us to eternal life. God of the living and the dead, accept our prayers for those who have died in Christ and are buried with him in the hope of rising again. Since they were true to your name on earth, let them praise you forever in the joy of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Bow your head for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. Amen. May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and Holy Spirit. Go in the peace of Christ. Thank you.
now. Let's take the time. Let the shack outside the game. And you know what I'm talking about. Just let me know if you wanna go to that room out on the range. We got a lot of nice girls.